What is going on, everybody? Just wanted to make a super quick video. Very exciting time in the Madden year right now. Madden coming out officially in the next week or so, but EA Access dropping supposedly tomorrow, a Wednesday evening. So that's super exciting for everybody to get their hands on the game. So just wanted to make a quick video kind of going over what I think the meta might look like right off the bat as soon as the game comes out, and then talk about kind of the schedule of my videos that's going to happen whenever a Madden 18 drops within the next week or so. So meta-wise, based off of all the gameplay I've seen defensively, I think it'll be some type of man-to-man defense unless they patch the zones on like day one. I know a lot of people have been complaining about the zone coverage, and I agree, it does look pretty awful. It looks like basically everything gets open, like almost any route combo, just any deep crossing routes. Seems like bench would still be really, really good. Corner strike, stuff like that. The zones just don't, the deep zones don't look good at all, basically. EA said that they would play a lot better and have better logic behind them, but they look basically identical to last year's, maybe even worse in my opinion. So I think man-to-man coverage will probably be the first thing a lot of people try. I know if you watch Lights Out, Madden Daily's videos, he predicts that cover one will be the defense a lot of people flock to. I think that could be the case. I do think that based off of what I've seen, a lot of the cover one, it still scares me because it seems like post routes are doing a really good job of getting over the top of man-to-man coverage. And if that's the case, then you have to leave that middle deep third in his coverage. I know a lot of people last year who ran cover one based defenses would put cloud flats on the outside and then user that deep third safety, because you didn't really have to worry about getting beat over the top. And I'm talking about with like off man-to-man coverage in the gameplay. Even with off coverage, it still seems like these deep skinny post routes are getting behind their man, and you could basically bomb it almost every time. So if you have to leave that deep zone out there, you can't use it as safety. And then I guess you could run some type of just stock, you know, rush four, leave the safety out there, have five guys manned up, and then user a linebacker who's normally like in a hook curl over the middle or something, or a three receiver hook. But if you do that, then you don't have the cloud flats on the outside, which could get abused by corner routes or C routes, depending on how effective they are against man-to-man this year. They look to be pretty effective. It remains to be seen how effective shading is when it comes to defending those types of routes. So maybe if outside shading this year is a lot better and it takes away those corner routes and C routes, maybe you won't need the cloud flats. Maybe you'll be able to shade to the outside and then user anything over the middle. So maybe that becomes an option. I guess it kind of is remain to be seen. Whenever everybody gets their hands on the game, it'll become a lot clearer if that'll be a viable strategy or not. Offensively, I think that basically what you're going to see, a lot of people are going to probably try out some of the new formations. I think bunch will still be pretty popular off the bat as long as the zones are how they are. Right here, pulling up on the right side of the screen, you can see I got this screenshot from a Lights Out's video, basically showing off some of the playbooks. You see this play Z spot and go, basically corner strike concept on the left along with the Z spot concept on the right, in terms of the flat route and the corner route. And then the Z spot route, the typical Z spot route, runs basically a stop and go down the middle of the field. Now this play looks basically like it's literally a combination of Z spot and corner strike along with basically a super delayed seam slash post route. So I know this is going to be a play a lot of people flock to as soon as the game comes out. So be prepared to face it online if you are going to be jumping online right away. I can guarantee this is going to be a play a lot of people go to. This is in Gun Bunch Offset. Now, out of Gun Bunch Week, which Lights Out showed in another video, which was in the West Coast offensive playbook, it looks like Z-Spot did get nerfed. As you could see in the previous frame, whenever Z-Spot was up in the same window as Z-Spot and go, it didn't have the same deep post right here. It's got kind of a weird inside curl route instead of that backside deep post, which was basically what made it so effective last year, that skimbo post. So you can definitely see Z-Spot probably not going to be as effective out of Gun Bunch as it was last year. It looks like that was kind of their way of nerfing it, but Corner Strike's still there. Obviously, everything else, PA Post still in the game. Everything else that made Gun Bunch good is still there, along with this Z-Spot and GoPlay. So it remains to be seen kind of how much that's going to affect it. If that was the only nerf and then it kind of got buffed in other areas, along with zones playing how they're playing. And obviously, Gun Bunch, very good formation to beat man-to-man coverage out of. So if man-to-man is the meta, I think you can expect to see a healthy dose of Gun Bunch again, which I know nobody wants to hear after, you know, facing it for the past 10 months. But that's kind of the nature of the beast. People are going to go to whatever is popular and whatever works best. So I think that could be what you expect off the bat out of the online meta. Now, video-wise, whenever the game comes out, obviously, there's not going to be many tournaments for me to really go over and talk about. I will be doing that as soon as they play those tournaments. I'm sure the first tournament will probably be some type of challenger or underground event, but I'll definitely be checking that out and doing breakdown videos of what I see, basically different concepts, different gameplay, you know, the championship game, stuff like that. So definitely be on the lookout for that type of content. But basically, when the game comes out, always going to do Madden Sunday School on Sundays, try and help newer players integrate into the community, kind of give them a foundation to learn a knowledge base, to kind of get their feet wet in the competitive Madden scene, and just have that foundation, those building blocks to kind of expand off of. Now, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, I would like to do either tip videos or breakdowns. Obviously, at the beginning of the year, it's going to be more geared towards tips because of the fact that there won't be those tournaments for me to break down. So probably for the first few weeks, you can expect, you know, tip videos on those days. And then finally, on Friday, I want to do kind of like a meta breakdown, meta report type of deal. I'm still trying to figure out exactly what it's going to be, but I'm thinking maybe like a 20 to 30 minute video, basically of me kind of talking about what I think is in the meta right now, what I think is popular, what I think is good, what I think's not good. Maybe a playbook tier list is something that crossed my mind potentially as something I might be interested in doing. I think that'd be a lot of fun. If you guys would be interested in that, definitely let me know. So maybe something like that, maybe meta predictions, what I think will be good down the road, what I think might get patched, stuff like that. I think that'd be a lot of fun to talk about and kind of interact with you guys, get your opinion on that type of things, on those types of things. So I think that could be interesting. That's kind of still something that's floating around in my head. I'm not 100% sure if that's what I'm going to do, but I'm leaning towards that way right now. So I'm going to go ahead and say that I will end up doing it. So that's kind of what it's going to be. 5 videos a week. That's what I've been doing. If you guys have noticed my schedule, basically Tuesday, take Monday and Wednesday off, and then Thursday through Sunday have a video on each day. Now, I might go to 6 days a week. If I do, then it'll probably be Wednesday will become that 6th day, and I'll still kind of give you guys a break on Monday. I don't know if you guys want to see videos coming out from me every single day. Obviously, I want the quality to be really good as well. I don't want to sacrifice quality to get more quantity out there. So maybe 6 days is something that I could do down the road. We'll see. But for now, basically planning on those 5 days of the week, definitely 100%. So let me know what you guys think of the schedule. Let me know what you guys think of, you know, what I kind of talked about the meta. Maybe if you guys have your own opinions on what you guys think the meta will be like whenever the game first comes out, definitely be interested in hearing those thoughts. Since it's very interesting just hearing kind of like Lights was talking about what he thought would be the meta. It's always interesting hearing other people's opinions. So I'd be very interested in hearing you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you for taking the time to watch. And until next time, guys, take it easy.